this is Catherine. Welcome to Double O Kidney. In today's video, how to defend yourself from the coronavirus outbreak. Should you wear a mask? Should you avoid contact with people who have been traveling? The media is giving you a lot of worrisome information about the coronavirus outbreak, but they never tell you exactly how to defend yourself from it. And especially if you are suffering from kidney disease or other chronic illness, the info of today's video can be really, really useful to protect yourself and your family from the coronavirus. Because, as you may already know, those more at risk are the elderly and people with chronic conditions like kidney disease. So, if you're part of these people, watch today's video very carefully because I'll cover everything you need to know to defend yourself and your family from the coronavirus outbreak. What are the precautions for coronavirus? How is the coronavirus transmitted? What are the signs and symptoms of coronavirus? And should you worry about catching this virus? So, this is what I'm going to show you today, because almost 10,000 have been already infected by this deadly virus. This cousin of SARS is a virus that causes respiratory problems, but can also cause diarrhea, fatigue, shortness of breath, respiratory distress, and even kidney failure. As the outbreak is rapidly growing, even outside of China, many people are wondering what they should know, what they should do, and what precautions they should take to avoid being infected with the coronavirus. This new virus in China is already considered a global emergency. So being prepared and having an action plan to protect yourself and your family from it is really important. So remember to send this video to your family and friends and anyone you may want to protect from the spread of the coronavirus. Okay, let's start immediately. The first thing we need to know is this one. Why is 2019 novel coronavirus so dangerous? The novel coronavirus has killed 213 people in China and infected almost 10,000. More than 100 cases have been confirmed outside China. Worryingly, it seems to transmit more readily between humans than SARS, a similar coronavirus that killed almost 800 people after it originated in China 17 years ago. Computer modeling at Imperial College London and Lancaster University in the UK suggest that each new coronavirus case is infecting on average about 2.5 other people. So far, novel coronavirus has caused severe respiratory disease in about a quarter of the confirmed cases and killed 2 to 3% of patients. For comparison, seasonal flu has a mortality rate well below 0.1%. About 25% of people infected so far are getting severe illness and require hospitalization. But experts warn that fatality rates are hard to estimate in the early stages of an outbreak, and the virus may mutate as it passes between people. It is also impossible to predict whether genetic changes will make it more or less virulent. Although 2019 nCoV isn't the first disease of its kind, the world as we know it in 2020 is not the same as it was in 2002 or 2012 when the previous two coronavirus outbreaks, severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, and Middle East respiratory syndrome, MERS, made their mark. Now, 2019 nCoV is thought to be far more infectious than SARS, according to scientists. What is coronavirus? Coronaviruses in general are an extremely common cause of colds and other upper respiratory infections. These viruses are zoonoses, which means they can infect certain animals and spread from one animal to another or from human to human. The novel coronavirus 2019 nCoV can actually spread to humans from animals or from human to human. Chinese health authorities firstly reported a group of cases of viral pneumonia to the World Health Organization, WHO, in late December 2019. Many of the ill people had contact with the seafood and animal market in Wuhan, a large city in eastern China, here at the center of the big red circle. Though it has since become clear that the virus can spread from person to person, there is still no vaccine for it because of reports that the initial cases had links to a large seafood and animal market. The virus is thought to originate in animals. What are the symptoms of 2019 nCoV coronavirus? Like two other human coronaviruses, MERS and SARS, the 2019 nCoV or the Wuhan coronavirus is known to frequently cause severe symptoms. The most common symptoms can include a cough, possibly with a fever and shortness of breath. This can often progress to pneumonia. These symptoms may appear 2 to 14 days after the exposure. There are some early reports of non-respiratory symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. Many people recover within a few days. However, some people, especially the very young, elderly, or people who have a weakened immune system, may develop a more serious infection such as bronchitis or pneumonia. And they are also a lot more at risk of dying from this virus. So older people and people who were already sick before contracting 2019 a novel coronavirus seem to be getting hit harder. How is the infection from coronavirus treated? Scientists are working hard to understand the virus, and Chinese health authorities have posted its full genome in international databases. But there's still no vaccine for it today, and there are no approved antivirals for this particular coronavirus, so you can only treat the symptoms of it. Most people with common human coronavirus illness will recover on their own. For the sickest patients with this illness, specialized aggressive care in an intensive care unit, ICU, can be life-saving. Now, as I was saying, those more at risk for complications are people with a lowered immune system, like the very young, the elderly, and people with chronic illness like kidney disease. So, if you are concerned about your symptoms, you should see your healthcare provider. But also consider that the symptoms of the novel coronavirus are similar to the symptoms of the common flu. So, don't get too anxious if you have fever and cough, right? Now, let's get to the main point of the video: what you should do to protect yourself. Can face masks help protect against infection? Now, masks are selling out very quickly, and not just in China. So if you are at risk, or if you travel a lot or spend time in crowded places, you may want to know what to buy, because not all the masks on the market are going to protect you against the coronavirus. As you can see, I have two masks pictured here. One of these can help you and the other one cannot. So, which one of these will help you and why? Now, there's a problem with this virus. Experts don't yet know exactly how the 2019 nCoV virus is transmitted. This is why the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is recommending that healthcare workers treat it like an airborne pathogen. Germs that can travel in particles or droplets in the air. That means healthcare workers interacting with a coronavirus patient should wear a heavy-duty mask called an N95 respirator. Like this one that I have here. These respirators are designed to fit tightly around the nose and mouth and, when worn correctly, block out at least 95% of small airborne particles, according to the CDC. These masks are totally different from the surgical masks you often see doctors and nurses wearing around hospitals. I'm talking about those cheap disposable masks that often come in blue or green. You can see a picture here. Now, if you want to protect yourself from the coronavirus, maybe because you live in an area where the virus is spreading, or if you travel a lot, you're going to want to use just one of these two masks. The N95 respirator I have here. The surgical mask you see here is not made to prevent people wearing it from getting sick, right? That's what an N95 respirator is for. But wearing an N95 respirator is serious business, and if you have ever tried to use one of these, you may already know that's not an easy job to use them properly. First of all, it's actually hard to breathe in one of these. They are uncomfortable. Then you have to know how to properly wear and how to remove them. Experts note that how you remove a mask, be it a surgical mask or an N95 respirator, is also very important. If you touch the front when taking it off, you could end up contaminating yourself. So you would have to be very careful and not to touch it on the front. Also, these are not a warranty that you're not going to catch the virus, right? In other words, they do provide some benefit, but they are far from foolproof. Remember that scientists still don't know how 2019 nCoV is transmitted. So there are also other precautions you should be taking. I'll show you what they are in a moment. Now, wearing a mask, even a cheap surgical mask, could be a good idea if you have respiratory symptoms and you need maybe to go see your doctor. This way, you wouldn't be spreading anything and you won't infect other people. And if you live in the US or in Europe, experts say that there's no need to wear a mask as a form of prevention, since the risk of catching the Wuhan coronavirus is considered low. It's totally different if you are in one of the affected areas though. While N95 respirators are available for the public to purchase, there's no recommendation from health agencies for general public to wear them. Today, almost all masks are already in back order on Amazon.com, for example, and this outbreak is just started and things can get even worse in the future. Still, my advice is not to rush out and buy a mask. Leave them for the people who need them, like the healthcare workers and ill people, so as not to contribute to mask shortages. So there are things way more effective you can do to avoid getting infected, right? Okay, let's see what they are. How to lower the risk for infection. You may be able to reduce your risk of infection by doing the following. Wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds or use a hand sanitizer that contains alcohol. By the way, antibiotics do not work against viruses, only against bacteria. So antibiotic wipes, soaps are useless regarding the antibiotic element. Regular alcohol wipes will work much better. Avoid close contact with people who are sick, especially people exhibiting respiratory symptoms and fever, and also avoid crowded areas. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with unwashed hands, because that's how you get infected with this kind of virus. So keep your hands away from your eyes, nose, and mouth until properly sanitized. Stay home when you're sick. These are the same advice you can use not to get sick from the flu. And actually, these advices may be a lot more useful not to catch the flu rather than this coronavirus. Why? Well, there is something we should consider about the coronavirus that most of the news websites and television news are avoiding telling you. Maybe deliberately or maybe not still, you're far more at risk of dying from the regular seasonal flu rather than the coronavirus. The coronavirus killed 213 today and it's going to kill more. But for comparison, seasonal flu infects so many people that around 400,000 deaths a year worldwide are attributable to flu. So we are talking about 400,000 deaths caused by the seasonal flu and just 213 caused by the coronavirus. As of today, January 31st, there are just 6 confirmed cases of coronavirus in the US and 3 in Canada. All of these patients have been hospitalized. In Europe, there are 16 cases. The virus obviously is spreading a lot faster in Asia, and there's even a case in the Philippines and one in India. Obviously, the situation gets worse the nearer you get to China, where there are almost 10,000 confirmed cases and all the 213 deaths reported. These numbers are going to get worse in the next days. I can guarantee that. Now, this is a serious issue, but the health infrastructure of both Europe and the US are well prepared and are responding very well to the issue. We can see that very well from the news. So, should you worry about catching this virus? Well, if you are in the US or in Europe, in India or in the Philippines, not so much actually. We are talking about less than 30 controlled cases, right? They may seem a lot, but if we compare 30 cases to the whole population of these countries, I mean the whole North America, Europe, India, and the Philippines, it's not a lot. It's definitely not a real threat. So, unless you are in China, I don't think you should particularly worry about this virus, but get your flu shot. It is flu season after all. It doesn't offer protection against Wuhan coronavirus, but here in Europe and in the US, the flu remains the bigger risk to health. And well, don't go to China if you can avoid it, because that's where you will be a lot more likely to catch this virus, especially Wuhan and other cities in Hubei province. So, if you have planned a vacation there, maybe you should postpone it if you want to be safe. This is all for today. Stay safe and thank you for watching.